In that lecture today, I am discussing about effect on discharge over a notch or veer due to error in the measurement of it. The discharge over a rectangular notch or veer is proportional to the h to the power 3 by 2, where h is the height of the liquid surface above the sill of the notch. And over a triangular notch, our veer is proportional to the h to the power 5 by 2. Okay. Therefore, the following cases of error in measurement of head will be considered. Number 1, for rectangular notch or veer. Second, for triangular notch or veer. The discharge for a triangular rectangular notch veer is given by the equations which is calculated the above expressions in the previous lecture, that is the Q is equal to 2 by 3 CD L under root 2 G S to the power 3 by 2, and which is equal to the K to the power H to the K into S to the power 3 by 2, and the value of K is taken as 2 by 3rd CD L under root 2 G. Differentiating the above equations, we get dq is equal to k into 3 by 2 s to the power 1 by 2 into dh, and dividing second by 1, second equations, we divide the first equations, we get dq upon q is equal to 3 by 2 dh upon capital H, and show that the above expressions, an error of 1% in measuring H will produce 1.5% error in discharge over a rectangular notch or veer. Okay, therefore 0.5% is the error, occurred error. Now, triangular notch or veer, the discharge over a triangular notch or veer is given by the expressions which is shown here. Q is equal to 8 by 15 CD under root 2 G tan theta by 2 into H to the power 5 by 2. And therefore, is this expressions to be written as Q is equal to K S to the power 5 by 2. And where K is equal to 8 by 15 CD under root 2 G tan theta by 2. Now, similarly, the above expressions, now we can differentiate the above equations, that is the dq is equal to k 5 by 2 into h to the power 3 by 2 dh. And now dividing same fourth equations by third equations, we get dq upon q is equal to 5 by 2 dh upon h. This expression shows that an error or 1% in measuring H will produce 2.5% error in discharge over a triangular notch or veer. Okay. Now, similar, we can solve the example based on that error. Now, example is taken as given as simple, a short example which is shown in the below. Find the discharge over a sipolite pier of length 1.8 meter when the head over the veer is 1.2 meter. Take CD is equal to 0.62. Now we come on the solution part. Length of veer L is equal to 1.8 meter, which is given in that example. Head of water is equal to 1.2 meter, which is given. Coefficient of discharge CD is equal to 0.62, which is also given. And now, using the relations, Q is equal to by the relations of the discharge over rectangular veer. That is the Q is equal to 2 by 3rd CDL under root 2g s to the power 3 by 2. Now putting the all terminology which is given in the example, and we solve, therefore the discharge q is equal to 4.33 meter cube per second. That is the discharge of this crested weir. Now next one is the discharge over a broad crested weir. Thus the below shown figure, that is the broad crested weir, which is the length of the weir. Here upstream side of the height of the water and downstream depth of the water. Let capital H is the head of water in the upstream side of the water, weir or water, and small h is equal to head of the water on the downstream side of the weir. V is equal to velocity of the water on the downstream side of the weir, and L is equal to length of the weir, and CD is equal to coefficient of discharge which is given. Therefore, now applying the Bernoulli's equations at section 1 and 2, we have pressure energy is 0, kinetic energy is also 0, but head is present, that is the capital H. And now therefore in second section, that is the pressure energy is also 0, but kinetic energy and head is present. Therefore kinetic energy is how much? That is the V square upon 2G, that is the kinetic energy, and head is small h present there. Therefore solve these expressions, and now the velocity of that water on the crested weir, broad crested weir, is how much? V is equal to under root 2g capital H minus small h. Therefore the discharge over weir Q is equal to CD into area of flow into velocity, CD into length into height into velocity. Length into height is the area, and velocity multiplication of the velocity, where velocity is calculated above under root 2g capital H minus small h, and it is solved this expressions, and therefore the discharge will be maximum if h into h small h square minus capital small h cube is maximum. Therefore d upon dh h square minus h cube is equal to 0. Therefore small is it can be solved, and therefore finding the value small h is equal to 2 by third capital H. Okay, therefore putting this value in the expressions, q max is equal to CDL into under root 2g under root h into 2 by third h whole square minus 2 by third h whole cube, and therefore solve that expressions, and therefore the value of after the solving these expressions obtained as 1.705 into CD into L into h to the power 3 by 2, which is the discharge over broad crested weir. Now discharge over in narrow crested weir, therefore in case of narrow crested weir 2L is less than capital H. This weir is similar to a rectangular weir or notch, and hence Q is given. Therefore Q is equal to 2 by third CD and into L into under root 2G into H to the power 3 by 2. Now next type is the discharge over an ogee weir. This is the ogee weir, ogee type weir. Okay, here sharp crested. Okay, in that figure ogee weir, in which the crest of the weir rises up to a maximum height of 1.115 h capital H, and then falls, as shown, where capital H of the height of water above inlet of the weir, at that the sharp crested weir point of the ogee weir. Therefore ogee weir is the same as that of a rectangular weir, and is given by Q is equal to 2 by third CDL under root 2G into H to the power 3 by 2, that is the discharge over an Auger crystal, Auger weir. Okay. Now next type of the weir is discharge over submerged or drowned weir. A weir is said to be submerged or drowned weir if the water level on its downstream side is above its crest. Such a weir is shown in figure 9.11, which is shown here. This is the type of submerged weir. The total discharge over the weir is obtained by dividing the weir into two parts, the portions between upstream and downstream. Water surface may be treated as free weir and portion between downstream water surface and crest as a drowned weir. The diagram of the submerged or drowned weir is given below. The upstream side of the depth of water up to the crested up to the top surface of the water is capital H, and the downstream side of the small h. Therefore, difference of the water pressure head difference is H minus small h, where capital H is equal to height of the water on the upstream side of the weir and small h is the height of the water on the downstream side of the weir. Then Q1 is equal to discharge over upper portions, that is the Q1 is equal to 2 by 3rd CD1L under root 2G within bracket capital H minus small h to the power 3 by 2, and Q2 is equal to discharge through drawn portions, and therefore CD2 into area of flow into velocity of flow, and it is CD and CD2LH under root 2G H minus small h, where CD1 and CD2 are the respective discharge coefficient at the point 1 and 2, which is where the discharges Q1 and Q2. Total discharge of that type of crest, submerged type of crest, that is the Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2, and it can be calculated as 2 by 3rd CD1L under root 2G capital H minus small h to the power 3 by 2 plus CD2LH under root 2G capital H minus small h here. Okay. Now a small example based on that maximum crested type of weirs. A 45 meter long broad crested weir has 0.5 meter of water above its crest. Find the maximum discharge over the weir. Take CD is equal to 0.62 and neglect velocity approach, and therefore we come on the solution parts, and now solve that example. A length of the weir is, that is the 45 meter, height of the water on the weir is 0.5 meter, and value of CD coefficient of discharge is 0.62, that is unitless constant quantity. Maximum discharge Qmax is equal to how much? That is the 1.705 CD into L into S to the power 3 by 2. And now putting the all values which is calculated above, and therefore Qmax is equal to how much? That is the 16.82 meter cube per second. That is the discharge over a broad crested weir of long 45 meter, which is calculated that way. Now next example, find the discharge over an Auger weir 6 meter long and having a head of 0.4 meter of water. Take CD is equal to 0.62. Now therefore the solution is, first of all, given that given value, length of the weir is 6 meter Auger weir, height of the water on the weir is 6.4 meter, and the value discharge coefficient is CD is equal to 0.62. Therefore discharge, the given formula using the that relations, Q is equal to 2 by 3rd into CD into L under root 2G H to the power 3 by 2, and now putting all these values which is given in that example, and now calculate the discharge Q is equal to 2.779 meter cube per second, which is the discharge. Okay, now next topic is time required to, which is very important topic and fluently asking in your examinations, like your university examinations and as well as in your class test and as well as in your competitions, UPPSC, State Engineering Services, all your competitions purposes, this is the very important. Time required to empty a reservoir or a tank with rectangular and triangular weirs or notches. First, rectangular weir or notch. Consider a reservoir or a tank provided with a rectangular weir or notch in one of its sides. And let us consider that A is equal to, capital A is equal to uniform cross-sectional area of the tank, capital L is equal to length of the crest of the weir or notch, H1 is equal to initial height of the liquid above the crest of the notch, capital H2 is equal to final height of the liquid above the crest of the notch, and CD is equal to coefficient of discharge, and let capital T is equal to time required in seconds to lower the height of liquid from H1 to H2. That is the time required to empty the tank. Further, let small h is equal to the height of the liquid surface above the crest of weir or notch at any instant, any time. Small dh, the fall of liquid surface in a small time, that is the dt. Therefore, minus adh, because negative sign, it is depression, it is the downfall, is equal to q into dt, and putting the value of the q is 2 by 3 cdl under root 2g s to the power 3 by 2 into dt. Negative signs indicates that at as t increase, h decreases. Okay, therefore dt is equal to minus adh, and rearrange that terminologies. And now again it is the integrating up to the limit is 0 to 2, and second right hand side to be h1 to h2. This is the taken as the integral up to the h1 to h2, and therefore now integrate that part, and we come on the discharge time 3a upon cdl under root 2g within bracket 1 upon under root h2 minus 1 upon under root h1, which is the expressions for rectangular type weir for the imputing the tank. Second type of the weir, that is the triangular weir or notch. Consider a reservoir or a tank provided with a triangular weir or notch in one of its sides. Let us consider capital A is equal to uniform cross-sectional area of the tank, and theta is equal to angle of the notch. H1 is equal to initial height of the liquid above the apex of notch. H2 is equal to final height of the liquid above the apex of notch. And CD is equal to coefficient of discharge. Further, let small h is equal to the height of the liquid surface above the crest of weir or notch at any instant, any time. Therefore, dh is equal to, that is the fall in the depth of the water liquid, depth of the liquid is equal to the fall of liquid surface in a small time, that is the dt, is how much, that is the minus adh is equal to q dt, which is that expression. Now again the putting the value of the q for the triangular sections of the weir notch, that is the c 8 by 15 cd tan theta by 2 into under root 2g h to the power 5 by 2 into dt. And therefore, rearrange that terminology, that is the dt is equal to minus a dh upon 8 upon 15 cd into 10 theta by 2 into under root 2g into h to the power 5 by 2. And now, to obtain the total time for 0 to 2, integrate at the right left hand side, and now the integrate above the right hand side of that expressions up to the limit taken as h1 to h2, and therefore solve these terminologies. We obtained the expressions, and therefore solving that above expressions, we have the discharge of the that crested wear, triangular crested wear is imputing the tank is time to required 5a upon that is the dt, that is the time required t is equal to 5a upon 4 into cd into 10 theta by 2 into under root 2g within bracket 1 upon h2 3 to the power 3 by 2 minus 1 upon h1 to the power 3 by 2, which is the expressions for the imputing the tank for using a triangular crested wear in your reservoir. Now next topic in that lectures we continue. The next topic is free liquid jet. A jet of liquid issuing from a nozzle, whenever that term is used, that is the jet, therefore the nozzle is required, nozzle is compulsory, and which is shown in here, that is the below side of that nozzle. Nozzle is atmosphere is called a free liquid jet because the nozzle is in atmosphere, atmospheric pressure, and the parabolic path is to be followed, that is that called trajectory. This trajectory is called this path is called trajectory because this is under action formation of the gravity, because the force of gravity. Let us consider the jet A make an angle with the horizontal direction. If capital U is the initial velocity of the water jet, then U cos theta is what horizontal component and U sin theta is vertical component of the velocities respectively. Consider another point xy on the center line of the jet which is seen above. Therefore, the total height of the trajectory is capital small h, and small u is equal to velocity of the jet at point P, that is the x direction, and v is the velocity of the jet at point P in y direction, and t small t is equal to time required taken by the liquid particle to reach from A to P point. Then small x is equal to the horizontal distance, x is equal to distance is equal to velocity into time. It is the basic expressions we used based on the Newton's law. X is equal to u into t, and u is how much, that is the u cos theta into time t. Therefore y is equal to how much, u sin theta into t ut minus half gt square. Therefore u sin theta into t minus half gt square, and therefore it may be noted that horizontal component of velocity capital U is u cos theta, which remains constant, whereas the vertical component u sin theta is adjacent by gravity, therefore it is the variable quantity. From equation 1 we have t is equal to x upon u cos theta, and putting this value in equation 2, therefore y is equal to u sin theta into x upon u cos theta minus 1 by 2 g into ut square, that is the x square upon u square cos square theta, and solve this expressions. Therefore y is equal to x tan theta minus gx square sec square theta upon 2 u square, which is this equations is shown as that the parabolic equations, and therefore the jet is to be followed a parabolic path. Now, the maximum height attained by the jet which is taken as small h and how much the value of h. Using the relation v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. Therefore, v2 square minus v1 square is equal to minus 2gh. Negative signs is used as a particle is moving upward. Where v1 is equal to initial velocity component, that is u sine theta, and v2 is equal to 0 at the highest point, particle is at rest. Therefore, putting the all values and gives out this expressions, and now final the height of maximum height gained by the particle up to the time t is h is equal to u square sine square theta upon 2g. Now, next expression, that is the time of flight, that is the capital T, which time occurred of the particle to travel on the air. The time of flight is the time taken by the fluid particles in reaching from A to B, and from equation second we have y is equal to same distance s is equal to ut plus half gt square, it is the Newton's law of the equations, and y is equal to u sin theta into t minus half gt square. When the particle reaches the point B, therefore y is equal to 0 and small t is equal to capital T. Therefore, the expressions, solve that expressions, and which is given as t capital T is equal to 2 u sin theta upon g, and the time taken to reach the highest point t dash is equal to t by 2, that is the half time, and t dash is equal to u sin theta upon g, which is the time required to maximum gain the maximum height of the particle. Horizontal range of the jet, that is the r, the range r of the jet is total horizontal distance traveled by the fluid particle, and then a small r is, that is the distance ab. Velocity component in direction into time taken by the particle to reach from a to b, u cos theta into t, therefore u cos theta into time t is how much, that is the 2u sin theta upon g. And therefore, solve these expressions. Therefore, r is equal to u square sine 2 theta upon g, which is the range of the particle free jet. And therefore, the range will be maximum when sine 2 theta is equal to 1. Therefore, theta is equal to 45 degree. Therefore, r max is equal to u square upon g, which is the maximum range of the trajectory. Now, based on the free jet, free jet nozzle, is situated in at a distance of 1.2 meter above the ground level, which is shown in the diagram, that is the 1.2 meter, and is inclined at 60 degree. The diameter of the nozzle is 40 millimeter, that is the diameter of the nozzle, and the jet of water from nozzle strikes the ground at a horizontal distance of 5 meter. This is the range of the trajectory. Find the flow rate, which flow rates to be flow the nozzle. Therefore, first of all terminology to be written, that is the distance, that is the range of the nozzle trajectory, angle of the inclination, diameter of the nozzle, d is equal to 40 millimeter, therefore 0.04 meter, area of the nozzle, pi by 4 d square, and which is calculated 0.001256 meter square. The horizontal distance, x is equal to 5 meter, which is given, and therefore coordinates at that point, x is equal to 5 and y is equal to minus 1.2 meter. Point M is vertical down by 1.2 meter. Therefore, the equations of the jet given by the y is equal to x tan theta minus gx square upon 2u square cos square theta, where u is equal to velocity of the jet, and therefore flow rate q is equal to, using that relation, y is equal to x tan theta minus gx square sec square theta upon 2u square, and putting all the values and solve, therefore u is equal to 7.05 meter per second, which is calculated, and therefore the flow rate q is equal to area and velocity, and which is the discharge of the flow jet free jet is equal to 0.00885 meter cube per second, which is the flow rate. This is the another type of example, and now we solve with the help of that expressions. And this is another type of example. This is another type of example.